Hi everyone, Success Coach Michelle Weimer here with this week's Masterful Mindset. So our thought this week is, doubt kills more dreams than failure ever will. So my question for you is, do you let self-doubt get in the way of fulfilling your dreams? And if so, are you ready to overcome that so that you can continue to pursue those things in your life that matter to you most? So, you know, as we continue our conversation about the monsters in our mind and how they get in the way of us achieving our success, this self-doubt is a big one. Self-doubt can really overshadow you and get in the way of you going after your dreams, pursuing your dreams, taking a leap of faith to, go after what you want. And the interesting thing is that self-doubt can easily be overcome by some of the things we've been talking about all month. So first of all, you know, last week we talked about getting clarity. And that's the first thing in terms of eliminating self-doubt or dealing with your self-doubt is to get clarity. Have a plan. If you know what you want, you're very clear about it, you have a plan for how to get there, then it really can help curb that self-doubt that comes up when you start to think, oh, I don't know what I want. I don't know what I want to do. I don't know how to do this. That plan that you have in place, that clarity that you have about what you want and why you want it, that's a huge help in terms of moving past the self-doubt and continuing on the path, continuing on the journey. It just helps you stay on track. The other thing that we've been talking about this month, we talked about a couple weeks ago, is that inner critic and the judgment that we have upon ourselves. So the second thing that you can do to really curb the self-doubt is to stop the inner critic and eliminate the judgment about yourself. You know, judging something, if you can look at your mistakes and your failures, or maybe things just didn't quite go as planned, as a learning opportunity, if you can put on what I like to call the observer's eye and see it through observation and just, you know, kind of look at it and go, oh, well, this is interesting. This didn't quite work out like I wanted. What could I have done differently? What was it that just didn't work out? You know, really learn from those experiences rather than judge them into saying things that the inner critic would say, like, oh, you're such a loser. I can't, you know, you failed again. You're an idiot. And, you know, whatever. I don't know what you say to yourself, but I'll admit I've called myself an idiot before. but, you know, just pull back from the judgment and see things through the observer's eye and really just learn from your experiences, from your mistakes, from your setbacks. You don't have to go into self-doubt and think, I'm not good enough, I can't do this. You can simply just see it, learn from it, and move forward. And then the third thing that can really help with your self-doubt is to have faith. You know, instead of having so much doubt in yourself, have faith in yourself. Believe in your ability to figure things out. You know, you don't always have to know exactly how to do something. You don't always have to have all the right answers. You don't have to do things perfectly. You just need to have faith in yourself that you can do it, and have faith that even if you don't know what you're doing, you can figure it out. So those are three things that you can do this week. And I want to challenge you to just really be aware of when self-doubt comes up for you and how it stops you in your tracks. You know, we've been talking all month about these roadblocks that come up that keep us from achieving our dreams. And this is a big one, but you can eliminate it or, you know, at least get a handle on it by doing these three things that I mentioned this week. So put that into practice. And I'd love to hear from you. I'd love for you to share with me how you are doing this month with having more courage and going after those things that you want in your life. So either comment below or send me an email, you know, get on the contact page of my website. You can send it from there. You can send it to info@michelleweimer.com. Whatever the case, I'd love to hear from you. And keep at it, okay? Keep working at that courage. You got this. Until next time, this is Success Coach Michelle Weimer. Goodbye for now.